there was nobody standing near me that I could turn and grab and say, oh, look at that.
Colours, characters.
Action and life.
Colour in the background, the shadows.
Just blow my mind.
That piece of sculpture had such an effect on me the very first time I came into the gallery.
I used to love, as a kid, conjuring up these stories in my head when I was walking around the gallery, look at different paintings of who these people were, what their lives involved.
Of all the parts of the story that Burton could have chosen to depict, he showed this quite peaceful moment. They're choosing to try and hold this moment and remember this moment. This is the thing that they want to be thinking of as they both face the end.
The painting conveys a lot of emotion. It really is not trying to be something very nice. It's kind of like heavy metal for art. Definitely very moving in a heavy kind of way.
Well, I guess some people think that they're outdated or they are kind of dated, but you know, at some point in time, it meant a lot to someone. In those times, they didn't have cameras, you know, there was no such thing as like Instagram, or if you go into that mindset, you would find a different frame of appreciation for these works.
There's this little moment on the wall that you can peer at for a very long time and still find really interesting things that kind of relate to the kind of life that you might have yourself.
My two daughters were small, they used to go to ballet lessons, and it kind of reminded me then a bit of one giving the other advice of what she's doing wrong and what she shouldn't be doing.
I associate excitement. I think everyone's quite gritting their teeth to see who wins.
Like, the first time I looked at it, I was just like, I just saw a load of colours coming out my face. The second time I looked at it, I saw loads of different shapes and the kind of colours coincide with each other. And then the more I kind of got into the painting, the more I looked at it, it was actually telling a story.
You don't see everything at the one time. You have to go back and you look at it again, you see something else, you know? That's the great thing about paints. And they're always changing. You'll always see something different. And so they're kind of a living thing.
Like coming here once a month or as soon as I can, and it just helps you to think in different ways.
It's a place where you can see really, really beautiful things in a very, very calm space. And I don't think you have to be that highbrow. You need to just connect with the things that you really, really love and make you feel, you know, something inside.